We are art. A lot of work went into this film and amazing ideas from the director. Unbeknown to us what he was really up to. There's a lot of depth in Rocky Horror. And when Jim Sharman, the director, was asked about making the movie, Alan Ladd Jr. had just taken over 20th Century Fox, and he wasn't keen to make this movie at all. And except people like Mick Jagger and Bowie all wanted to play Frankenfurter. And Jim Sharman, the director, said, absolutely not. Tim Curry or no film. And also, thankfully, Pat Quinn, Magenta, we're from the original stage show. So we were there while songs were being written and brought in overnight. You know, we were in an amazing melting pot of talent, from the designer to the director to the actors. So it was like an amazing creation of something, script coming in overnight, things happening. And then we opened the show on the stage, and at the end of 3 weeks, it was a 3 week run and then finished. And the end of 3 weeks, Mick Jagger, Bianca and Elliot Gould were queuing up to get in. So we were a hit from day one, and it was extraordinary. And the greatest thing was that Sharman stuck to his guns, and they made out, well, if you want that lot, this is the budget, like a million and something. If you have the others, we might go to 10 million. He said, I want that lot and I'll do it for the million. Way! And we won. I mean, I've always wanted to act. Well, I was in the church play, first time I acted, and I'm from Belfast, Northern Ireland. And I was coming down the road and this woman said to my mother, she's very good, you're a wee girl, Mrs. Quinn. And I looked at her and thought, oh, I didn't know I was very good. But so then from then on, I then joined the Drama League in Belfast as a girl. And then at my secondary school, my grammar school, I was with part of the... So I was playing Puck in Summer Night's Dream at the age of 12, you know. So I just went on and on, and I just had to be an actress. It was a passion, and it has to be a passion, or you won't do it, you know. And a lot of people today, young people, say they want to be famous. And you think, what does that mean? Famous for what, you know? They don't realize what you have to do. And I actually got on the boat at 17. I was in the Arts Theatre in Belfast as a professional. Acting and ASM, that's assistant stage manager backstage. You had to do that, you know, at that age. And then I thought, I'm going to London. So I got on the boat from Belfast and my father set up with a journalist at the quayside at the docks in Belfast. And he set up this picture and I'm standing like that on one of the bollards, you know, that they tie the ships to, you know. And I'm standing like this, and it says, headline is, Countdown for Stardom. And that was in the Belfast Telegraph, because Daddy set that up, okay? And I've got it, it's been everywhere, that picture, actually. And it was like, so I went to London, and had to begin from, I became an usherette in the theatres so that I could see all the plays, and started to work. So it's extraordinary because it's a hard road, but it's great if it works.
That was just my look, and Sue Blaine sort of just went off what suited me, and that's how I came to that look. And I guess in part of me is just playing myself as Columbia. I didn't think I thought about it.
What's your name you are?
I'm very spur of the moment kind of a gal, impromptu, wild, but. Also, I was very lucky. I was born into a happy, large family. I'm one of the four children. And I had loving parents who were very encouraging. And I think that is a key thing. So the four, myself and my three siblings, the four of us, all have confidence. We were encouraged to go into whatever area of work we felt inclined to. And that's been a key thing. I mean, I absolutely love looking at paintings, sculptures, looking at a tree. And music is obviously inspirational. I mean, when you hear a song you love or music you love, it's absolutely thrilling.
And look, I'm here 40 years later talking about this movie, and I've just done this Q&A, and as I say, it was like, I tell you, I've been doing this for quite a while. I mean, when I first did this, I said to my agent, what is this I'm auditioning for, this Rocky Horror thing? He said, I think it's something about a circus. And he wasn't wrong. I've been in this circus ever since. For 40 years, I've been in this circus. This circus has taken me around the world and back. It's been extraordinary. And when 20th Century brought out the DVD, they paid me to go to Sydney and sent me around the world to sell it and promote it. But I had to do a yak and, you know, massive interviews. And then I was at the Gay Mardi Gras in Sydney. That was astonishing. But I said, could I go on the Rocky Horror float? Because it was a Rocky Horror float at the Gay Mardi Gras. And they said, no, you have to be in the room watching, you know, so the TV cameras, you know, you have to do interviews. You can't go on the float. And when the float came around, I thought, thank the Lord I didn't go on that, because they're singing the Time Warp for the whole of the Gay Mardi Gras. It would have killed me. And then it was amazing, because they opened the Gay Mardi Gras with Dykes on Bikes. Okay, boom, boom, boom. And there they were in their like San Francisco caps and blondes with their hair flying. Dykes on Bikes. And I thought, oh my God, it's just like Eddie, you know? Like Meatloaf. Boom, boom, boom.
How do you feel about the influence that art has on people?
You know, because I sort of work in the arts, I see its effect on a daily basis. And it's, besides just raising one's intelligence and one's behavior in the world, it affects your eyes, it affects your optics, it affects how you visualize and create your own world, and turn help create others. And it all has to do with the artist's vision first, and how they have the ability to communicate to you through their unique vision and help you change yours and hopefully create a better, happier, more compassionate world.
Do you have any insecurities that may have hindered your success?
I think periods of my life where I haven't had the self-confidence, and I've always had people encouraging me, and that hasn't been an issue. It's the issue of me encouraging myself and accepting their view of who I am and what I'm capable of. And so until you internalize it, you know, until you internalize their acceptance and vision for you, you know, it's very difficult to get past that, because we just keep tripping ourselves up. I know in acting and films and things like that, unless you're totally comfortable and accepting of your right to be there and your right to take your time to do your work, you can't really succeed at it. And it's the same thing with an artist or a photographer, I think. You have to be willing to battle your demons and battle the maybe some of the naysayers and to stay on course.